The Mukono High Court Judge Henry Kawesa has given a custodial sentence of 30 years on remand in Luzira Prison to Dr. Matthew Chirabo for the murder of his then-girlfriend Desire Mirembe in 2015. Security was tight at the High Court in Mukono as Matthew Chirabo arrived from Luzira with the prison's bus, surrounded by both prisons and police as he was escorted to the court cell. Inside the fully packed courtroom, mainly dominated by Desire Mirembe's relatives, it was a moment of sorrow and grief as they waited for the judge, who later came and requested for a Lord's Prayer before the case. Prosecutor Happiness Ainebiona read out the charges against Matthew Chirabo for the murder of Desire Mirembe, who was a Makerere University medical student who would have been a valuable person to his family, and asked the court to give Matthew the punishment he deserves.
I know that's prosecution. We pray that this court proceeds to sentence the convict under section 82.
Judge Henry Kawesa gave the deceased's father a chance to say something in court and gave his opinion on how his life, as well as the lives of his family members, have changed drastically ever since the late departed from their lives. He also gave his opinion on the type of sentence that should be given to Chirabo amid his tears from his family, and he also explained to the court the psychological trauma he has been facing with his family.
My life has been taken away. I don't know what I can say. For 8 years. Since my daughter has been murdered, my life has never been the same. The family has been broken up. My son does not even sleep home. Everybody abandoned the home. I don't know what I can say, but Chirabo did a very, very terrible thing to our life.
Dr. Matthew Chirabo apologized to Desire Mirembe's relatives for the trauma they have gone through. However, he denied having murdered her. He also cited that the video, which was submitted in court as exhibit when he confessed to killing Mirembe, was done under pressure and torture from the police during the time when he had just been arrested and detained at Nalufenya.
I was saddened as well, especially because I wasn't able to mourn the death of my friend.
After a full hour of court break, Judge Henry Kawesa sentenced Matthew Chirabo to 30 years since being a first-time offender.
Mitigating factors which have been laid before court move this particular sentence away from the death penalty because it has been shown that the convict is a first offender. It has also been shown that it's a father. It has been also shown that he is currently the custodial sentence of 30 years.
The relatives of the deceased, led by Desire Mirembe's father, Emmanuel Musoke, welcomed the judge's decision. They thanked the court for the just decision after 8 years.
Today, we have come to the conclusion of the case of Desire Mirembe, my daughter, who was murdered in the year 2015.
Personally, I believe this guy we have sentenced for life sentence. Because I know, I think it's like 32, 33 years. If he serves 30 years, meaning he'll be getting out of prison like 26 years, he will resume where he started from. Look at the scenario. For me, I call him a beast.
The victim, now the late Desire Mirembe, was Chirabo's girlfriend and Makerere University student at the time of her demise in July 2015. Mirembe was murdered after a misunderstanding with her boyfriend Chirabo, and her body was dumped in a sugarcane plantation in Lugazi in Buikwe District. Story compiled by Joanita Nakate for the news.